Might be wondering why the top of the washing machine is not on the washing machine. We were diagnosing again, and I had, if you remember from the last video, like
9 days ago.
Was it 9 days? Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Well, we had a massive link clog, and it worked after we unclogged it. And
for now, 9 days.
Yeah, and then it was having the same error code, like it wasn't draining. So I'm like, oh, I must have missed some. I'm thinking it's my fault, right? And so I checked, and there wasn't any lint in there. So I'm like, hmm. So I took the top off, because somebody else had said in one of the other videos, they commented, say, hey, usually they just take the fronts off these things. So I'm looking, I'll do what I know how to do, because I started taking the front off, and there's all these different screws, and I'm like, man, I'm going to lose these things. But while I had the top off, I pulled the, see these twin drain tubes down here?
Yes.
Right here? I pulled that up, and this right here is a, just an air vent, just to keep, I guess, pressure from building like a vacuum or something. I don't know. But I pulled that from off of where that is, and it was clogged. So I went ahead and used a little, my high-tech paperclip tool, like MacGyver or something, and I was able to unclog that so air could go through there. I'm like, well, maybe that was it. So no, that wasn't it either. And so I'm listening to it. It's, the pump's trying to run, but clearly it's not running. So I do what I did in the previous video, so you can watch that if you want to, and pulled the pump out, and the pump motor, when I touched it, it was hot. So it had been trying to pump, but the motor was blown. Ooh, while I've got the camera running, check this out. You can actually see, where did I have it? Babe, where did I put the bad one?
I think you put it somewhere.
Remember it was cracked?
Yeah.
Pause it, I'll grab it. So, here's, it's got the magnet looking one that slides in here, but this is the actual pump housing. And water had been getting in there. The seal must have gone bad. There's a rubber seal that goes around here. And you can see this is not supposed to be cracked, and it's actually cracked on both sides.
It was stinky.
It stinks. So I'm guessing water got in there when the motor was hot or whatever, and it just cracked it. So fortunately, we've had enough of these go out that I have one on hand at all times now. So I'll be ordering a new one so I can replace it the next time it goes out, because I'm sure it will go out
unless
again.
I throw it out the door first.
Well, you know, if it works with 2 hours of repair time every time, 2 hours, what am I worth per hour, do we think?
I don't know. We probably spent...
What am I worth
we've
an hour?
We've had this,
like,
what,
20
four,
bucks an hour?
5 years,
like,
tops.
My day job, I'm probably worth like 20, 25 bucks
but
an hour.
But we had
so
this 5 years tops,
is,
and we probably would have spent a couple thousand to get it repaired.
I don't want to spend a couple thousand dollars right now.
I know, I'm just saying.
So anyway, while we got it open, if you want to, if you're interested, it said, well, you've been pausing me too long, it turned off. So if you look here, if you've ever been interested what the insides of these looks like, here's where you put in your soap, right? And it, over here, they know what that looks like. They don't know what this looks like. So, your water comes in here, and it'll, depending on what cycle you're using, what kind of pre-washes you're using, these are the electronics that activate and deactivate the switches or the valves to let the water go, rinse those in, and then it goes through this hose to have your water and soap solution or fabric softener or whatever into your drum. So that's kind of neat to just see that. This is a 2-in-1 dryer slash washer, and this is where the magic happens right here. This is the condensing unit. So you can see coming off of this, where the cold comes in, this puts cold water into this unit, which cools off the surface. So it's just like dew in the morning. The hot air will come up out of the drum, pass through this cold apparatus, and that's where the water from the air gets condensed onto that surface. That's how this thing works. That's how you, there's no vent like a regular dryer, because it condenses.
And no special outlet.
No special outlet either, just regular 110. It condenses the water right out of there. So it heats the air so that the moisture comes out of the clothes, and then it condenses that moisture onto this cool part, which is cooled by that cold water. So pretty neat. Let's show them what it looks like with the whole thing moving too. This is kind of fun. And we were just trying to run a drain and spin, because these clothes are clean now, But we got to get them spun out. I don't know what you're doing up down there. They can look through this on their machine. What you normally don't see is in here. And actually, if you grab, let me have that. And yeah, oh, you can see our cat box and everything. So this is a direct drive, which is one less thing to go wrong. Ah, sounds wonderful. There you go. It's a direct drive, no belts. And I do like that. It's got a 10-year warranty on the direct drive motor, because they know it won't. There's nothing to go wrong there, so they can warranty that a more full amount. And here we go. Starting to spin those clothes a little bit. And these things are suspended. You've got a spring mounted to the chassis right here, drum to chassis. One over here. There's another one on the other side. And that's what keeps this thing from going completely crazy once it's spun up. I'll just shut up now and let you watch this drum. Might take a couple minutes before it goes to the high-speed spin cycle, which is pretty impressive. These things spin, I think they said 1300 RPM, something like that. And it's to get as much moisture out as possible so that the dryer doesn't have to do as much. Whew. Man, it is a little warm in here. I'm hoping it's louder than normal, partially because I have the top off. Otherwise, that new pump, which is actually an old pump, it did pump some water out though, so we'll see. And this vent here is just for pressure equalization and that sort of thing. There we go. Heavy weight on here too, I suppose, just to kind of give it some balance for when the back ends flop around. This kind of balances the front, I suppose. That is the pump that we're hearing, and it is pumping water. A little at a time over here. Not at the moment, but oh, there comes the water. Of course, when I drop it. All right. Good thing we've got that waterproof, air quote, flooring. Smooth out as it speeds up. These machines take quite a while because they're constantly turning one way, speeding up. Oh, it's not balanced. And then they slow down, go the other way to try to keep that load balanced so that this vibration is kept to a minimum. It's starting to get going pretty fast.
Oh, all of a sudden it just kind of smoothed out a little bit. Yeah, maybe. Every time I do a repair on one of these things, I'm always like, is this going to be the moment where it just explodes because I did something wrong? Notice I have a pan underneath this thing because I've just never trusted it. Of course, that's not this washer in particular. I always try to put a pan under them in case there's a little leakage. Really getting up to speed now. Wringing the rest of that water out. It all looks well, so I'll probably go ahead and kill this video and button her back up. Have a good one.